live in the good KML studios with my good friend P-Lo.
Hello, how you guys doing?
How are you doing, brother?
Man, I'm hanging out. You know, it's a pleasure to be here with you, man.
It's a pleasure to be here with you, man.
You know,
during the holiday season, since you got the big event going on, before we get started, tell everybody about your big Halloween event.
Man, P-Lo at the Fox Theater with Murr Beats and Offset Jam on Halloween night. Make sure you get there.
What made you want to put that together for the kids, man?
Man, you know, I just want to do something special always for Halloween, you know what I'm saying? Or just, you know, just for the Bay Area, you know, it's just where I'm from, and I want to just put on something special, make sure everybody come out, have a good time, positive time, you know?
If we're going to do that, we got to make a special Halloween pumpkins.
Yes.
They've given it, I do not know how to draw, so mine's going to be crazy off top.
My mind is going to be a little nasty also.
Well, we're gonna work ours together. Yeah. We'll have some talks, okay?
Yeah, come on.
So, you've been on the road, huh?
Yeah, man, just been trying to spread it, you know, just trying to
spread what, your seed?
No. I'm trying to spread the Bay Area cheer, you know, all across the country, you know? You're crazy. I'm calling the police.
I like the way you stop right there on the top. No.
I've just been trying to spread the Bay Area love all across the country, you know?
How important is it to spread Bay Area love, man?
It's very important, you know what I'm saying? I feel like we're always underappreciated, and I just want to make sure we make our presence known in music, you know what I'm saying? Because I feel like we contribute a lot, so I feel like it's good that we have more people out here representing on the front lines for us, you know?
What's the biggest part of our culture you want the world to see?
I think the biggest part of it is I want people to realize our originality and our uniqueness and our progressiveness to what the world should be. You know what I'm saying?
What is the biggest misconception of Bay Area since you travel on the road? Because you know, when you go out there, they go, you're from the Bay. What's the one thing they always say to you and you go, we don't do that?
They think LA and the Bay are
next to each other.
No, they are next to each other. Yeah. And we're pretty far from each other. So that it creates a different lifestyle for both sides. And that's cool. You know what I'm saying? But we did definitely get the common misconception that we're right next to LA. So, yeah.
What is the most tiring question someone asks you when you do these interviews?
What's some tiring question?
Where you just go, oh God, don't ask me that shit no more.
I don't know. I don't have a problem.
It's gotta be something you just be like, you know what, don't ask me that no more.
What is like, or people always ask like, or what's P-Lo stand for?
People ask that?
I mean, yeah, people ask, what's P-Lo stand? I was like, that's just my name, you know what I'm saying?
I've never thought to ask that before, ever in my life. Why do they call you P-Lo?
I mean, yeah, my original name is Paulo.
Right.
So, you know, P-A-U-L-O, and just P-Lo, you know what I'm saying?
So it was a childhood name.
Yeah.
Do you ever lie and make up a story?
No.
Come on.
No. I can't.
You say because the P hang low. Focus.
Wow. Well, it looks like I got one.
And you
it looks
can
like
use
I got
it.
One.
You
yeah.
can use it. You can use it. You
it
can
looks
use
like
it.
I got one.
You can use it. You
thanks
can.
To Big Bond. We got a P-Lo, a fake P-Lo story.
Hey, that's extra merch you can sell.
Sweats.
With the bulge in the front.
With the. Come
get,
on, bro.
I get 10%.
Come on.
I got 10%.
Hey.
You gotta make a song to go with it, though. So you can, like, come on a stage and it'll be flapping up and doing
yes.
all
this.
Hey, man, I'm only here to help, man.
Hey, marketing you got, hey, ideas.
All day.
Ideas are things.
All day. You know these. Come on, man.
Ideas are things.
So when did you know this thing was really working for you? This whole rap thing.
I mean, the first time we ever came up here was you.
That's when you knew it was about to pop off the first time?
Yeah, I mean, when we first came to see you, I just knew we can achieve it. If we got this far.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like you gave us that belief. Because I feel like, you know, coming up from the Bay, like, always just in Kimia, like, people really wished that, you know what I'm saying, that your music gets played on, especially on KVL.
Like, right.
You know what I'm saying? And I feel like when you first brought us up here, it was like, we were like, whoa, this is like,
this is it.
This is like, oh, we can achieve things if we can just, if we just really just like hone in on everything, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like you were definitely a big part of that, you know what I'm saying? Especially, you know, me, and you always showed me love, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think my first song that you heard was like, it wasn't even a rap song. It was an R&B song.
And that was what I was about to go with my next question. Cause when we first kicked it off, it was all the guys was rapping, and you was really on your R. Kelly. Not like that.
Yeah, no, not that R. Kelly. Not that version of R. Kelly.
We're gonna say Trey Songz then. You was on your Trey Songz.
Yes.
And I could tell, like, cause all the guys, they was making records. It was, you know, Beat the Coochie Up. One guy had a song called My Penis Ain't Racist.
Yeah.
And then it was, what was the other one? My Penis Ain't Racist.
Ass.
and One Text.
Yeah.
So everybody was really on some real sexual stuff.
Yeah.
But then you came with the ultra smooth joint. I was like, yeah, you a singer?
No. But you know, I aspired to be that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, I've always been one with the ladies.
Right.
So I just want to make sure, you know, that they know that I'm noticing that,
right.
You know what I'm saying? So that was something that I always wanted to, you know, dabble into and you know, get my feet wet.
Your feet wet, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Not only my feet.
Are you ever gonna go back that route?
I dabble on each project on, you know, something of that sort.
Yeah.
You know, I would definitely want to dive in more with it, just because, like, I mean, everyone loves R&B.
Yeah. Now, when your shows, man, they got a lot of energy.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people jumping up and down, going back and forth. Have you ever just wanted to come out there and croon it out?
Yeah, actually, there's one song in the set where I croon it out.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like to what? Because you was rocking the vest with no shirt for a long time, showing the guns.
Yeah,
you back to doing that?
Not that deep, but like, I definitely bring a fan on stage and then I sing them a song.
Oh, no, you're not doing the lift them up, carry them around joint, are you?
No. Not that in depth.
Why not? Why have you not done this yet?
Not
I've
in
seen
depth.
Usher do this, and so many times they lift them up and carry them around the stage, you know?
Yeah, no.
No. What's wrong?
You're
young, you got a strong back, brother. You could do it.
I don't know if I want to get, you know, that intimate yet.
Not yet.
It's
part of the game, man.
Yeah.
How you been dealing with your stardom?
I don't know. I treat it regular, you know what I'm saying? I'm still me. You know, I'm still a human at the end of the day. Like, I was out walking around over there by the Chase Center earlier.
Yeah.
So we walked all the way from, like, stashed all the way here. So, you know what I'm saying? I was just walking through the streets, you know?
Yeah, but you don't know, there's like loads and leagues of kids that dress like
now. Yeah. I mean, yeah, but you know what I'm saying? I think, you know.
It is just, like, I can tell. I'm like, yo, they look like little pillows out here. This is crazy.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I think that's what I want to inspire. You know what I'm saying? I want to be able to, like, touch people and you know, inspire them to follow whatever they want to do. You know
that's
what I'm
dope,
saying?
Man.
And you know, chase their dreams, because I'm still in my dream. You know what I'm saying? Just like I said, like, even like the first time we came up here with you was like, whoa, we at KVL, Big Von. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I probably got like that in memory of like us first coming here. That's something I won't ever, like, I won't forget that. Especially, like, I remember we were sitting in front of JR's car, and I feel like it was when you played Yes on the radio. We were sitting in front of JR's car, and his he had this maroon Altima. It was like a 90 something.
Yeah.
We were just like sitting there waiting. I was like, oh my God, they're playing P-Lo Yes on the radio. Like, they're my songs on the radio. And it was just like insane. And that was a long time ago.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that stuff don't leave me. You know what I'm saying? That's like, I feel like you were a big part of like bringing all of that here, and especially here today, you know what I'm saying? Because that was a long time ago.
It feels like yesterday, but it was a while ago.
It feels like yesterday, but it was a long, long time ago. So just to be able to still be here talking to you is like a, you know what I'm saying? It's an honor, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, cut it out. You're making me blush, man. Y'all don't know, we like really friends though.
Yeah, for real. No, for real.
Random places all around the world.
No,
for real. Let's go over here, man.
Come on, man.
Look at that over there.
We have to go to, we were just talking about it.
Toronto.
Earlier. To Toronto.
Carabana.
We're coming to Carabana. 2020.
The Pilo show is coming.
Yeah, we coming. We coming to Carabana.
I don't care what I got to do. If I got to sneak across the border, I am there. I'm back for it.
Yeah, no, put me in a Big Von suitcase. Smuggle me over there.
And what's the next big thing you got coming out, man? What's the next goal you want to achieve?
I mean, I just want to be able to keep spreading the Bay Area sound all through the world. You know what I'm saying? That's something like this. That's like my own personal goal. You know what I'm saying? I have other goals, like my team has goals and everyone. I just want to be able to keep pushing the sound forward and being at the forefront of Bay Area music.
I heard that, man. And your production's been getting crazy.
Yeah. We got some cool production stuff coming out too. So
some stuff you work with people?
Yeah.
Like who, brother?
Oh, another Bay Area artist.
Humpty Hump?
Hopefully. Hopefully. K-Line, we got some cool stuff coming out, some K-Line stuff.
Okay.
So we just working on her album, so you know what I'm saying, she's coming
so. So you got some treats coming, huh?
Some treats.
See, the way you smiling, I can tell that you got some heat.
Some treats.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So we just working, man, and just working on more new music, just like just keeping it going, trying to, you know, I want to be back up here more, you know what I'm saying, hanging out with you.
You come hang out anytime you want, man. Door's fully open. Tell them about the project that's out right now.
Man, go get my new album, Shine, featuring Kehlani. Kehlani's actually on there. Mm. She's on a single, it's called Sneeze. Mm. So she's on there. Who else is on there? Sheesh, I'm like blanking out. Who else is on there? Holy moly. Oh, Mazi's on the album.
Okay.
Man, it's some of my best music. So I'm just happy to, and we're on the Shine tour right now. So just being able to tour off music is such a special thing. You know what I'm saying? Going to these different places outside of the Bay Area, and people are just like showing love, and like, especially like in New York, we sold out the show in New York, which was like
crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
People so far away knowing your music is
like,
nuts.
Yeah, no, for real, man. And, you know, especially coming from here.
Mm.
You know, I feel like people always, like, try to, like, say our stuff is just regional or whatever. And just to be able to go out there and play a sold-out show in New York, one of, like, the toughest places to, you know what I'm saying, just to even, like, do something is I think, is a feat for me. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And I think that was one of my personal goals, was to be able to sell our show in New York. And I want to just do more and sell out a show. And I mean, we just came back from Japan off my stuff, so it was like, just to be able to even do that is like,
it's dope,
insane, you know what I'm saying? And it's just an honor just to represent like where we from, where, you know what I'm saying?
I heard that, man. I heard that. Now my $1 million question I love to ask, I ask everyone, it changes, it varies. You ready for it?
Yes.
What is dream merch you would like to sell to your fans?
Dream merch. Ooh, that's a tough one.
I know.
Dream merch. Oh, I wish I could, damn, that was a good one. I wish I could sell everybody a grill.
Pilo grills.
Yeah.
Word.
Yeah, that would be a good one. I feel like, what if it's like, okay, you get like this own like molding kit, and you do the mold yourself. But I feel like that's like,
you trying to actually sell mold at the shows?
Yeah. Well, what if you like did molds? You know what I'm saying? And we had like the little Chinese dude from East Oakland just like come through and just like and just look kind of like, you know what I'm saying, kind of do the mold, and then he's like, you know, he's back there just like whipping up the gold, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That'd be insane.
That'd be crazy. No one's ever done that. That's a good one.
Yeah, the little Chinese dude from Durant Square just like whipping
just
up.
Just doing them.
Whipping up grills, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like that'd be pretty awesome.
That's what's up, man. What you come up with?
Sean. My marker went out. So it's kind of nasty. It's pretty nasty. My marker went out, so that's how I was trying to like
fill it in a little bit.
Yeah, try to fill it in, but you know. Yep, that's me.
As far as like I was an Angry Bird pig.
An Angry Bird.
Remember Angry Birds?
Yeah.
Remember the pigs they used to whoop on?
Don't they have an Angry Bird movie that's out?
Yeah.
Damn.
I only got the eyes and the snout.
Yeah, but you know, yeah, I was trying to make like a grill, but it just went out. So I just, yeah, and we were just talking, so I just left it. But yeah, mine looks disgusting.
It's wonderful, brother. You did good. You did good. You put your best foot forward. You know
what
I mean?
Thank you, man. Thank you,
man. For all those out there watching, if you're lucky and you're in the Bay Area, you can go to the Super Show going on the 31st of October. Tell them what it is, man.
Man, P-Lo, Murder Beast, Offset Gym, At The Fox, The Shining, come through Bay Area.
Man, get the album. Tell them, make sure they get that,
man,
too.
Man, make sure you go get the album, Shine. Go get the new single featuring Kehlani, Sneeze. Yee!
I'm going to give it to my homeboy. He'll pretend it's a midget.
For our friend over here.